Good morning, everyone. My name is Jane. Welcome to the Burlington Online Service. This is our last Sunday in the Daniel Fast. I hope that you found the fast helpful, perhaps challenging this year. Were you able to connect with God in new ways? It is an excellent way to start a new year, especially in this lockdown. Hopefully, you found more time to draw close to God. We'd love to hear from you of your experiences. And now we join together to worship our faithful God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our hearts overflow with thanks. Kerry and the team will lead us in worship.
Never ending, reckless. couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
Thank you, Kerry. In a moment, we will take up our offering. Remember that if you usually give in church, you can now also give online to our ongoing work. Let us pray. Father, please accept our gifts. We give all that we have to be used in your kingdom. Thank you for calling us, each one, to do your will on earth. For equipping us with different talents and gifts, we are one body, diverse in our unity. Hallelujah. Amen. For the next 20 minutes, we will hear from a few people who have found this Daniel fast a fabulous way to start the new year. As we listen to their stories, why don't you think about your own testimony? What has God been doing for you in the past few weeks? And Becky will read to us from Psalm 77.
This morning's reading is Psalm 77. I cried out to God for help. I cried out to God to hear me. When I was in distress, I sought the Lord. At night I stretched out untiring hands, and my soul refused to be comforted. I remembered you, O God, and I groaned. I mused, and my spirit grew faint. You kept my eyes from closing. I was too troubled to speak. I thought about the former days, the years of long ago. I remembered my songs in the night. My heart mused and my spirit inquired, will the Lord reject forever? Will he never show his favour again? Has his unfailing love vanished forever? Has his promise failed for all time? Has God forgotten to be merciful? Has he in anger withheld his compassion? Then I thought, to this I will appeal, the years of the right hand of the Most High. I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. I will meditate on all your works and consider all your mighty deeds. Your ways, O God, are holy. What God is so great as our God? You are the God who performs miracles. You display your power among the peoples. With your mighty arm, you redeemed your people, the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. The waters saw you, O God. The waters saw you and writhed. The very depths were convulsed. The clouds poured down water. The skies resounded with thunder. Your arrows flashed back and forth. Your thunder was heard in the whirlwind. Your lightning lit up the world. The earth trembled and quaked. Your path led through the sea. Your way through the mighty waters, though your footprints were not seen. You led your people like a flock by the hand of Moses and Aaron.
So here we are, right at the end of Daniel Fast 2021. We've gone from surviving to thriving. It's been a great way to start this rather difficult year, and I've been encouraged by hearing from many of you how you've creatively fasted in different ways and the things that you've taken up to help you draw closer to God. We're going to hear now from a number of people who have fasted in different ways and who have experienced God as they've given something up and tuned in to his voice.
Okay, good morning, everyone. My name's Rich, and I've got the pleasure of talking to Steve Wilson this morning. And he's been doing something different this Daniel Fast. So, Steve, do you want to talk us through it?
Yeah, sure. This year with the Daniel Fast, I decided to create some music. In the past, I've tried to engage with the Daniel Fast by giving things up like food types and drink and stuff like that. And I've always found it difficult. And I thought there must be something I can do which is kind of more beneficial to me and to other people. So I decided to write some music, and as we were using the Facebook group, I thought, well, if I state on there that I'm going to do a piece of music every single day, that will kind of hold me to account. So I set about doing that. I had a little idea for a piece of music and looked at the Bible passage as well and started writing something. I didn't really know where it was going to go. And each day I wrote a little bit more. Typically did it the day before, so it was ready for the next day. And I found as I was reading, specifically Psalm 77, it was kind of really fitting with what I was writing. And then obviously sometimes I looked at the passage specifically and thought, oh, what should I do here? And I just found that particular piece of music just built as it went, and it turned out it kind of then fitted with what I was reading in Daniel as well. So it was kind of like, oh, this is meant to be, I think. and you know, posted it online, and hopefully it blessed a few people as the days went on.
Yeah, well, he certainly chose a good psalm, because that one's written by Asaph, who was a drummer. So yeah, well done. So how do you think the whole process linked you into God?
Well, the fact that it was almost my quiet time became my creativity time, and I was reading and I was writing at the same time, and so that kind of helped. I mean, one of the things as a consequence of writing it, I found that it had blessed people who had listened to it, and that in turn encouraged me as well, because people had listened to the music and had made comments about how it had actually spoken to them in that particular moment. One person in particular said that, especially that first piece I wrote where it starts off quite monotonous and then it kind of breaks through into something, it was indicative to them of how God breaks through in a kind of situation of everything just being mundane and stuff like that. So God kind of spoke to me in the fact that I had somehow helped and encouraged someone who listened to the piece of music, and that wasn't really something I was expecting at the time. Other people mentioned how it had helped them in their kind of other daily activities that they're doing and helped them find some peace. So that in itself was brilliant.
I think the whole response to your work has been amazing, and I think you should be really encouraged and proud of what you achieved. So well done, and I hope you can continue this after the Daniel fast.
Thanks. It's
been cool. Good. Thank you, Steve.
Cheers.
So I'm here again with Angela, one of our church family, and she's been spending a lot of time through the Daniel fast, just really praying and listening to God. He's been giving her pictures, and she's got another one to share with us right now. So Angela, why don't you share what God's been saying?
Thank you, Claire. God's so exciting to know. He just speaks to you in so many different ways. The other morning, when I got up, I usually go straight into my prayer time, but that morning I decided to read my old journal. Well, I started about 3 years ago, and as I read for about 20 pages, I realised I hadn't learnt anything. I was still going round the mountain and falling in the same old hole. And I hadn't taken on board all that he had been talking to me about. So I thought, well, I need to get out for a walk and think about this and have a prayer time while I'm walking for a change. So I went down for a good old 4 mile hike down Cordy's Lane, down to the river. It was great. It's just me and the Lord and nobody else around who deserve us. Anyway, on the way back, after having a good old rant and a prayer time and repent, the Lord reminded me of a little memory from years ago. When I was a carer at a care home, there was these two old ladies called May and Frances. Well, they were absolutely delicious. They were just gorgeous little old ladies. But they worried. They worried about everything. You name it, they worried about it. And one day, I walked into the lounge and they were sitting there giggling. So I went and asked them, why are you two giggling? What are you giggling about? And they said, well, we've been sitting here trying to figure out why we're worrying. We don't know. We're fed, we're watered, we're clean, we're warm. Everything's done for us. Why are we worrying? We don't know. And the Lord really spoke to me through this memory. In other words, I didn't need to keep trying to do something when he's already done it and answered it. And I just need to take on board what he's done and said to me and live it. And I just came home just on a hop and a jump and a skip. And it was lovely realizing that I don't need to strive to do something. He'd already done it.
So good, Angela. I mean, honestly, the joy of those two ladies as they discovered they had nothing to worry about, it just encourages me that we have great joy when we realise we're not in control, God is. And we have joy when we discover actually we have all we need in him. And even though this season is hard, we don't need to worry, and joy comes from that knowledge. So What an encouraging reminder. And I love how that took any guilt off you or any stress or any like striving and pressure. And you can just be a free child of God. How wonderful is that?
Yes, right.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for sharing that story, Angela. I'm sure that will be an encouragement to so many of us through this time. Thank you.
Throughout this Daniel fast, we've been especially conscious of those who have been really poorly with COVID. We've been praying for Harriet Rush and her dad, Lee, and the whole family as they have faced what has been such a hard and challenging season with Lee being in hospital. Sarah caught up with Harriet the other day and heard her experience of the Daniel fast in such a dark valley. Let's hear from them now.
Good morning, Harriet.
Good morning.
Good morning. So we're just talking about how God has been working in Harriet's life this morning. And about 3 weeks ago, something awful happened for Harriet. Her dad got COVID and he was rushed into hospital, wasn't he, Harriet?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he ended up in ITU and he's been there ever since, hasn't he? And he was really poorly for a long time. On a ventilator, but this week, as we've been recording this, we're seeing much more signs of hope, and Harriet's dad is rallying round and he's sitting up on his own and she's finally able to talk to him on the phone. So that's been really nice, hasn't it? Because it's been a really scary time for Harriet and her whole family. So Harriet, we're incredibly proud of the way that you've held it together these last few weeks. You've been caring for your mum, haven't you? You've been organising food and medication. And on top of that, you've really managed to stay really smiley and happy most of the time. So you've done really, really well. I think you're an inspiration to me. So I just wanted to ask you how you've managed to do that. So question number one, how have you coped, do you think, over the last few weeks?
People thinking about us and like praying for us the most, because like it's been quite a hard time, but knowing people like were thinking about us and like kind of cheering us on.
Yeah, that's good. So you've really felt lots of people supporting you.
Yeah.
Excellent. And how have you felt God at work in that?
Well, at first, we didn't have like carers or anything, so we had to do it all. But then it was like God called us to get carers, and that's now like made it so it's a bit easier, and it's going to be easier when Dad comes home too.
Yeah, so that's carers to help your mum, because that's what your dad used to do, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think Harriet's been really, really good at listening to God through this time. So about 2 weeks ago, she sent me a message saying, will you do this Bible plan with me? And it was all about how you hear from God in the darkness. And that's inspiring, I think, Harriet, to start looking for God when you're struggling like that. And I think that's really helped you, hasn't it, to work your way through?
Yeah.
So that's really good. I'm glad it's all starting to look a little bit easier for you now. What can we pray for moving forward? Obviously, we want your dad home, don't we, and better. But what else? What for you?
Like peace in it all, because when Dad gets home, it's not going to be as easy as it used to be. And like, he's probably going to not be able to do as much as he used to be able to do. And it might end up with caring for him a little bit. So like, kind of strengthen that as well.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, so as a church, we'll pray for that, for peace for Harriet and for full restored health for her dad. And don't forget, Harriet, we're still all here to help you. We were not just here for the short bit while he was in ITU, but we can help once your dad gets home as well, can't we?
So, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Before we move on to more testimonies then, let's pray together, shall we? Father God, together we have been praying for Lee and Harriet and their whole family. We pray today for them and for others who are so seriously ill with COVID at this time. We ask that all who are struggling in this way may experience your very presence and your healing power in their life again. We're on our knees, Lord, and asking for a change. Sweep through our nation with your power and your healing grace. We pray for nurses and doctors and hospital staff at this time, and we ask you are especially close to them as they face this season of absolute trauma and hardship. May they know your peace and your provision and your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to now hear from another couple of our church family who are going to share a little bit more about how they have fasted this year, but especially listening to, as Alice will share in a moment, some of the words that God has given them that perhaps are important for all of us to hear as we move into this year.
This Daniel fast, I've given up TV time and general busyness. And I've taken up a more focused time of reading, listening, praying, and then journaling what I sense God say to me. And he's certainly been speaking and joining the dots on various different topics this time round. But what I want to share with you is about being buried to grow and being hidden. Now, I love to garden, and frequently God speaks to me while I'm on my knees. And while I was planting a whole load of different flower bulbs in the autumn, I sensed God say to me that what I was actually planting was hope. When after all, no one spends hours preparing and planting and then doubts that what they've planted will actually grow. They plant in expectation, in faith, that there will be a beautiful harvest at the right time. And so my hopes and dreams have been planted in faith in God, that he will answer in his way and in his time. After all, no one will pick a flower when it's only just emerging through the soil. They will wait until that flower has grown and is fully formed and has reached its full potential. But bulbs and seeds need to be buried to enable them to grow. The dirt is put on top and that creates a pressure on the seeds. But the seed has everything in it that it needs to grow and to thrive. And when life starts just to break through the outer protective casing, that little seedling starts to push through the heaviness of the soil. It's getting stronger and it's putting down roots that will sustain it through adverse weather conditions. But in those early days of germination, there's absolutely nothing to see because it's all hidden. But that doesn't mean that there's nothing happening. And so with my life and yours, we pray, we dream, we hope with faith in our Father to answer our prayers. And even when it feels that we're covered in dirt, feeling the pressure of trials and not seeing anything happening, we are growing, we are getting stronger. And God is working in our situation. At the right time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. The song Seasons by Hillsong encapsulates this beautifully. And I'm also reminded of the scripture, do not despise the day of small beginnings. I was given a picture of me travelling through a tunnel, and it came to my mind again as I was walking the dog yesterday. And I felt God challenging me to pivot my perspective on the tunnel and see it as a blessing and not a curse. The tunnel keeps us moving in a set direction and it prevents us from veering off track. Because we can't see what's going on the outside of the tunnel, it keeps us protected, it keeps us from being distracted, and it stops the doubts from settling in. If we knew everything that was up ahead of us, we'd look through our physical eyes at the external factors and believe lies that we are not cut out for whatever God's got for us, that we're not strong enough, and perhaps we wouldn't even want it. We simply might just give up. But when we keep focused in the tunnel, in the struggles, it means that we forget what lies behind and we strain towards the goal. With our eyes closed, we see the vision. Now, God's just been encouraging me to be patient, to keep persevering, to keep trusting him for all that lies ahead. And I hope that this will give you encouragement too.
Good morning, I'm here with Jess, and this is the first time that she's fasted, so I'm really excited to hear how her experience of fasting has been. So Jess, why don't you tell us what you did to fast?
Yeah, so I started off with the actual Daniel fast diet, which I thought wouldn't be a big challenge for me because I'm vegetarian already, mostly vegan as well, but it actually turned out to be a massive challenge. Then I also did social media, no social media, and also included in that was doing a Bible plan every day instead of spending time on social media. And also part of the Daniel fast, a big part of it for me was the no coffee, because coffee plays a big part in my life.
Yeah, I mean, you really went for it. So first time fasting and you gave up some of the biggest things that most of us are addicted to. I speak for myself about the coffee. So how did you find it? I mean, those first few days must have been carnage.
Yeah, so I was doing it with my mum, which made it a lot easier because we had each other to support each other and to make meals with each other and all of that. But it was massively challenging. Like, I ended up feeling quite ill and also grumpy, just like miserable, because it was just really hard to find foods that after like a week that were exciting, not having the same thing over and over again. So it was really challenging, and the coffee aspect especially, because I drink a lot of coffee, and so not having that, I really had to find something else to rely on, which in turn I found that to be God, but it took a while to find.
Yeah, it really does. I mean, the coffee thing, I was surprised when I gave it up that how much of a habit it becomes. It's the first thing you do in the morning, often the last thing you have at night. And as you say, eventually you get to the point where I've got to just rely on you. But oh God, that it's so hard to give it up. It's so hard. So you said you gave up stuff, but you also took up things like a Bible reading plan. So just share a little bit, you know, what have you learned from God through this time of sacrifice and obedience?
So much. Like, just reading the Bible. Last year I'd probably picked up my physical Bible maybe twice, which is appalling. But actually reading the physical Bible, you just see how like alive it is, and doing soaps every day just showed me how God literally speaks to us with what we're going through, like specific things, which is just amazing. Like something really big every day that I'd then go through and pray about it. So yeah, really big discoveries about myself.
Brilliant. And just going forward, I'm assuming you're looking forward to your first cup of coffee.
I'm very excited.
Are there some habits though, and some of the things that you're going to take into the rest of the year?
Yes, I've discovered that caffeinated coffee isn't good for me. Health-wise, I've been so much better, and also a lot less anxious. So I've realised that coffee makes me anxious, and I really don't need to rely on it, and I need to rely on God when I feel like I need a coffee to wake me up or whatever. I just need God.
Yeah, absolutely. Brilliant. Oh, Jess, thank you so much for sharing what you have. That's so great.
Thank you to so many of you for getting in touch and sharing your story. This is just a glimpse of what God's been doing amongst us. So as we come to the end of our testimony time, I'm wondering, what's your story? What has God been doing in your life? If you were to be on film right now, what would you say about what you've given up, but what you have received from God? I'd love you to spend some time this week just recording what God's been doing. Let's not miss the moment. Let's not miss the words of life that he has for us. Spend some time reviewing, perhaps today, what God's been doing at the beginning of this year, and encouraging you as well to pray, Lord, this is the beginning of this year. I want you to be right at the centre, the Lord of the dance. Let's pray just for one another as we come to the end of our testimony time. Father God, thank you for what you've been doing amongst us. Thank you for what you've been doing in me. Thank you for giving me words of life at the beginning of this year. Help us all to live with you as the Lord of the dance, trusting you as the guide through our daily walk. Help us with the things that are good, and help us with the things that are hard. And may we walk into this year knowing that you go before us and that you are with us. So with grateful hearts, we thank you for what you've begun in us, and we're trusting you for what you're going to do immeasurably more in this year. In Jesus' name. Amen.
The Ipswich International Church have been on the Daniel Fast journey with us. We will hear a few testimonies of all that God has been doing with them.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to use this opportunity to thank God for this time of Daniel fasting. It has been a blessing looking at the book of Galatians from chapter 1 to chapter 3. One of the things that has stood out to me is the simplicity of the gospel. How, you know, the gospel is so very simple. Christ has paid the price for us. He died on the cross of Calvary. God raised him up from the dead. And that is what saves us. It's not our works. It's not our background. It's not anything that has to do with us. God was just so pleased to save us that he sent his son to die on the cross of Calvary for us. And it is making me deepen my confidence, this assurance that my salvation has been fully paid for. And one other thing is the opportunity to spend time with our sons, to explain our faith to them, making that contrast between what our faith is and what the law is. And it's interesting hearing them ask questions and being able to explain things to them. So those are the two things I want to give thanks for this time of Daniel fasting. I'll now hand over to Tracy as he shares her experience with us.
Hi, everyone. I just want to give God thanks for this opportunity to share with you. Well, Daniel Fast 2021. I was in some ways struggling entering into the fast this year for different reasons. For a start, fasting is always going to be a toughie right after enjoying all that lovely Christmas grub. But I always try and welcome it, and God's grace is amazing. And but this year I also struggled because we're in lockdown, so I wouldn't be able to physically spend time with my family. And due to a family breakdown, I'm living on my own at this time. So, but nevertheless, I entered in fasting, lockdown, and all with a prayer in my heart. And just really, my heart was that God would have his way in me through these 3 weeks, that he would just give me a deeper understanding of his word, that he would just stir me to pray. You know, a deeper place of prayer, and then I would just come out differently than when I entered. And as I spent time with him in the quietness, I just really enjoyed a new depth in my relationship with him. And you know, I just daily asked that he would reveal and deal with anything in my heart that is not of him, because I didn't want anything, and I don't want anything to hinder or contaminate my walk with him. And, you know, in retrospect, the fact that we are in a lockdown, it has in fact been a blessing in a way, because, you know, I've had the opportunity to spend so much more time with him, and through fasting, praying, reading his word, walking through Galatians together on the 6 a.m. prayer meeting, I just had that sense that Father's just really poured out his love and his revelation And I just have a new passion and a fresh zeal and an even deeper hunger for more of him, and a deeper understanding that it is because of his grace that I can have a relationship with him. And I'm just blown away. And I can truly say with every ounce of my being that he is my everything. And just to top it all, there was an amazing breakthrough during this time as well. And God answered a prayer that has long been in my heart. And he just made a way when it just seemed like there was no way. And I just praise him, and I just give him all the glory. And I thank him for his love and his grace and his faithfulness. Amen. Right, we're just going to pop right over to Maureen now, as she just shares how the Daniel fast has been for her.
Hi, everyone. The last few weeks we've been going through this Daniel fast and journeying through Galatians, as has already been said. But I found it enlightening and challenging and refreshing. And what stood out to me the most in it is, which you already knew, but it's just come afresh, that it's through faith by grace. It's nothing that we can do or buy or say or be. It's only by grace, through faith. And it just blows my mind that we're so blessed and it's so simple, but we sometimes make it so hard. And I just thank God for his grace in my life, and many times he's shown his grace so much, and I thank you that every day that grace is sufficient. So no matter what we're facing, every day his grace is sufficient to take us through, and that his promises are yea and amen. He would never break a promise, and that is amazing, because in this world it's full of broken promises, which leads to broken lives. But I'm just so blessed and thankful that we have this 6 o'clock prayer meeting. We have the privilege of meeting together. I mean, I've been on Shielding for nearly a year now. And, you know, it's hard on your own. But by God's grace, every day we get through and we get up to the prayer meeting, and it's wonderful to connect with our brothers and sisters and praise God and listen to his word. And I'm just so thankful for that. And it just reminded me of an old chorus that we used to sing. Only by grace can we enter. Only by grace can we stand. Not by our human endeavours, but by the blood of the Lamb. Into your presence you call us, and now by your grace we come. So I just say thank you, Jesus. Amen.
It's been a great morning. Thank you to everyone who has shared their story today. We would love to hear yours, so why not get in touch with one of the team or write something on our closed Facebook page about how you have encountered God through this time. Finally, a reminder that tomorrow we continue our Monday morning worship online from 9:30 till 10. We will be looking at Luke's Gospel. You'll find the details at burlington.church/gatherings. Well, it's time to say goodbye. God bless you and keep you safe. Have a great week.